How does it feel to win district finals?
Well, of course, it feels exceptionally well. You know, I mean, it's exciting for the school and for the community. I've done it before as a coach, so it's just nice to be back to be practicing this late in the year. As, you know, one of eight teams left in the state, it makes it special.
If you guys celebrated after the game, how did you guys celebrate?
Well, when Joe turned the corner on that last run, I knew that once I saw Joe get the first down, I knew the game was over. I was pretty far out on the field, and I kind of lost my air a little bit because I was so excited and just yelling with the guys. And so, you know, just typical stuff. Guys were hugging and just excited to make that historical first down and finish that drive. It's probably one of the most impressive drives I've ever been a part of to finish that game. So it was exciting for the players to get that. So we just kind of, you know, just enjoyed the moment. And, of course, the guys on the team took a lot of photos. And, you know, I was obviously there with them making sure nobody broke our new trophy.
All right, is there anything else you'd like to say to Carlos?
Yeah, I mean, you know, it was a special night, and the students made it special. You know, our student section was loud. The stadium was loud and exciting and crowded. You know, Mrs. Schultz putting together a pep assembly and really pumping up the students to support the team was a difference maker. I think Dexter thought they were going to come in and roll us, and our whole entire student body just kind of had our back. You know, so it's important to acknowledge that and just thank the students and the community for the loud support and the excitement. It truly does make a difference for the players. And I know that the players and I and all the coaches appreciate it. And of course, you know, thank them all the way.
Hi, everybody. This is Cam Ottenbright with Liberty University Hockey, and you're watching CTV News.
He knows this one.
Don't be racist because I'm like,
Good morning, Carlson. Thanks for joining us this Friday. It's game day. Everybody get hyped. And let's get into the news. The weight room will be open every Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday to all high school students after school from 2:45 to 4 p.m. See Mr. Danik with any questions. And kindness cards, once again, are back when you're caught being kind and receive a card. Simply scan the back and enter your information for a chance to win the monthly drawings. Still waiting to find out, see if I won a monthly drawing. You know, if you remember, I won a kindness card recently, so it's all brag. And there will be conditioning for anyone interested in wrestling at 3 p.m. Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. We will meet at the mat room. Our first official practice is Monday at 4 p.m. And now we're going to turn it over to our very special anchor, Sauce. He's back. Let's see what he's got for us with the weather.
Thank you, Bryce. You'll see me in the wrestling room Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. I'm going to be on the team, so I hope Bryce comes to my meets with Pimo. He's smiling at me. He doesn't believe me that I'm wrestling this year. Anyway, the weather for today is high of 52, low of 37, and it's partly cloudy. So, starting to be crappy weather. Got my coat on here. Good win Friday, boys. Let's have another one tonight. Let's go back to practice.
Thanks, Sauce. See you at the mats where I'm wrestling too. Better look out. All right, let's go back to the news. 10th through 12th graders, the Armed Services Vocational Aptitude and Battery, ASVAB, will be offered on November 14th. Sign up in the counseling office if you're interested in taking the test. And once again, best of luck to the Marauder football boys tonight against Waterford Mott. Let's get another dub. Let's keep it rolling. And just a reminder, tryouts for Marauder Bowling are Thursday, November 9th. Oh, that was yesterday. And Monday, November 13th at Woodhaven Bowlerama from 4 p.m. to 5:30 p.m. We ask that all bowlers, freshmen through seniors, attend both days. And boys basketball tryouts are November 13th through 15th in the main gym. Ninth graders will go from 3 to 5, 10th graders 5 to 7, and 11th and 12th graders from 7 to 9. You must have a physical turned in the athletic office or in your hand on the first day in order to try out. Best of luck to all of our winter athletes and their tryouts coming up. And that looks like all we got today. Once again, you know, I've said it twice, I'm going to say it again. Good luck to the football team tonight. Sauce, you're gonna be the difference out there. I feel it. You're going to lead this team to victory. But anyways, good luck, and we'll see you next week. Looking at the realest man. You see me break, break chains and hold me down. I make waves all around. I face danger every day. You know, I'm still unstoppable. Still unstoppable. I'm still unstoppable. Still unstoppable.
I'm a five-star linebacker at Anti-Vape High School. If I see you vaping in my halls, your ass is grass. Vape, 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 vape. What's that in your hands? Are you vaping?
Oh. E-cigarettes can contain harmful ingredients, including ultra-fine particles that can be inhaled deep into the lungs. E-cigarettes produce a number of dangerous chemicals.
You want to end up like this kid? I didn't think so. You got caught vaping. Don't vape.
Touchdown pass to number 17, Landon Vita.